Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I must thank the organizing committee lah for giving MaCGDI this opportunity to share our views and inspiration of our program MaCGDI. So the topic of my presentation today is MaCGDI current challenges and formulating the National Geospatial Blueprint. Ladies and gentlemen, I am aware that most of the audience today knew what SDI is. So it is my pleasure to do some revisit of MyGDI, the one and only SDI of Malaysia. As you all know, I think MaCGDI is an organization and MyGDI is a program, is a national program that MaCGDI embarked with. As you all know also, MyGDI is an entity of for the Malaysia, for the Malaysia as national SDI to represent for Malaysia, that is MyGDI. So the goal of this infrastructure is to reduce duplication of efforts among agencies, improve qualities, and reduce costs related to geographic information to make geographic data more accessible to the public, to increase the benefit of using available data, and to establish key partners with federal and state agencies so that it increase the data availability at our GDC, that is our one-stop center for Geospatial Malaysia. So here, how MaCGDI, as I mentioned earlier, can facilitate the specially enabled government or society. So geospatially enabled government is one that has ready access to geospatial or geographic or location-based information. So a specially enabled government manage information and process using special concept and technologies. So special enablement of government is a part of larger phenomenon now impacting the world, the special enable of societies. A vision of SDG might be a government action informed by knowledge of location. So geospatial enablement lead to reduction of administrative costs, enhance the research industry's development opportunities, improve decision making, and also increase the whole of government incomes. Ladies and gentlemen, while implementing MyGDI, we have came across many issues and challenges. Before I touch on the issues, I would like to bring our journey from when we start our the establishment of MaCGDI, where we embarking with the with our national program MaCGDI in 2002, and then in 2004 MaCGDI was subsumed to NRE with a new ministry, and then in 2011 we conduct an impact study for this program MaCGDI, and then in 2014 we have a strategic paper for development of 11 Malaysia plan, whereby through this paper we emphasize why we need to come up with one national geospatial blueprint or national geospatial master plan. Here are our present challenges. First issue that we encounter is regarding the legal. So there is no specific legislation relating to geospatial. So the existing legislation at the federal, state, and authorities and statutory bodies are silos and confined to their respective sectors. And then the second issue is regarding the sharing, whereby the existence of various constraints that contribute to sharing of geospatial information required for planning, development, security, and disaster management for the nation. And then the third issue is regarding the expertise development issues. As everybody knows, there's in terms of institutional problem regarding the personnel that been trained and then been transferred So it's been a brain drain for the organization. And then there's a lack of expertise in the geospatial field to meet the needs of government and industries. And then the fourth issue is regarding the ICT infrastructure, access and security, because of the insufficient and inadequacy of ICT accessibility and security to geospatial information. And then the fifth issue is regarding geospatial information. This one regarding the geospatial information management. There's a because of the lack of the geospatial management, there's a happened duplication of efforts in the collection, storage, and dissemination of geospatial data that contribute to inefficiency of cost, time, and human resources. And the sixth issue is regarding the governance issues, whereby the existence of various existing geospatial related to committees which are not coordinated by any country's highest level governance structure. As of now, our highest authority is only at our Secretary General at our ministry. Before we come up with a national geospatial blueprint or national geospatial master plan, so we need to conduct. We have to engage a consultant to do the study so that it come up with some deliverable to come up with our national geospatial blueprint. So before we come up that, we have to come up with a problem statement. So the problem statement before we conduct the study, before we get approved to approved from EPU to get the development budget, so we have to give a problem statement. So our problem statement to conduct this study is because of the irregularities of geospatial information management and activities across all sectors that contributed to the loss of revenues, and all this also threatened to the in terms of the security and the sovereignty of the nation. Here is the deliverables from our study. There are five deliverables. First, regarding the consultant need to come up with a draft for our national geospatial policy. And then the second, consultant also need to come up with a draft for the National Geospatial Act. And then the third one, for the national geospatial governance. And then the fourth one is regarding the National Geospatial Enterprise Architecture Framework. And the fifth is on the National Geospatial Strategic Plan. Here are some success stories of MyGDI. As what just now, one of our application is MyGOS. But although MyGOS, we have an application to come up with a shared platform, but actually we have already embarked with a public service transformation program on the geospatial or GIS cluster, whereby MACD is have to be the lead agency for the collaboration under strategic collaboration with all other agencies to use our platform so that from this strategic collaboration, it will optimize the resources and also reduce the cost and time. So the platform that we developed have been recognized by Public Service Department to be a platform for sharing the infrastructure for the future. So here is the collaboration, as I did mention earlier, the collaboration with the agencies involved. And then next, here is example, as I mentioned earlier, we are already embarked with one application, One Malaysian Map, whereby we open to agencies who want to collaborate with us. If there is any information they need to reveal to the public, they can make use of our platform they can make use of with our platform with a free of charge, whereby MaCGDI have already prepared the infrastructure. Either they want to be in terms of data hosting or application hosting or server hosting. So through this, we hope we can accommodate for the rakyat lah. That's why one of the reason why EPU, our central agency, allocate budget for us, because we try to fulfill the message from 11 Malaysia Plan, whereby pertumbuhan berpaksikan rakyat. That's why we come up with a map for community for Malaysia. We no need to depend on the Google Map, whereby our information will be revealed to the Amazon cloud. But for us, we want to use for the security reason. We try to accommodate with the government cloud. So the objective of our One Malaysia Map is. First is awareness of GIS to the public. To give the awareness to the public in terms of using the point of interest. And then the second is to provide sharing platform based on hybrid solution. That is a crowdsourcing based on the public who input the data, and then the agency who again verify the information that been given through crowdsourcing by the public. That's why we call it as a hybrid solution. And then the third one is on the secure sharing platform for the public, as I mentioned earlier, through our government cloud. And the fourth one is established as a one public geodatabase for our future reference. That's why our outcome is to come up with a one-stop center platform for sharing geospatial information between the agencies and the public. Here, the next application that we for the sharing purposes is through MyGOS. As just now we've been given as SAG. Actually MyGOS is an online geospatial services. It's also a content development platform, and is a platform for sharing and collaboration. For the further demo, will be demonstrate afterward. So next, maybe I just highlight regarding what MaCGDI being received internationally and nationally, some recognition. First, we have a Future Golf Award in 2014. We also embarked with ISMS certification, and also we are among the top five on the ICT Innovation Award for public sector in 2015 through Venom application. Here is what I just now go up to on the stage to receive a special achievement in this award for 2016 from Esri. Actually, initially is from Esri International User Conference at San Diego, California, at 29 June 2016. So actually, MaCGDI is among the selected agency from 350,000 agencies for the whole world. So we hope through this give some inspiration for our future. Okay, many thanks for your attention. I shall hand this session to Madam Sarifa Alia for a short demo on MyGOS. Thanks again for lending me your ears. Thanks.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan selamat petang. Pada hari ini saya akan tunjukkan mengenai sedikit agensi yang telah menggunakan platform MyGOS. Sebelum tu saya tunjukkan ini merupakan muka depan bagi Malaysia Geospatial Online Services. Okay, next saya akan tunjukkan ini merupakan web map yang telah dibangunkan oleh Kementerian Kemajuan Luar Bandar dan Wilayah, iaitu KKAW, dalam maklumat projek pembangunan luar bandar. Di mana Kementerian KKAW ini mempunyai projek-projek pembangunan di luar bandar seperti RTC, projek jalan kampung. Okay, next saya tunjukkan daripada Kementerian Tenaga Teknologi Hijau dan Air, iaitu KETA, di mana dia menggunakan operation dashboard untuk maklumat geospatial logi rawatan dan empangan. Next, saya tunjuk APM, Angkatan Pertahanan Awam Malaysia, di mana dia dalam pengurusan maklumat bencana. Seterusnya adalah daripada Jauhar. Dia menggunakan web app builder dalam MyGOS untuk geospatial, untuk pemetaan tanah wakaf di Malaysia. Seterusnya adalah daripada Pusat Hidrografi Nasional, iaitu dia membuat pemetaan bagi maklumat ramalan air pasang surut. Maklumat ini dia mempunyai bacaan air pasang surut bagi tahun ini dan dia mapkan untuk satu Malaysia. Okay, next adalah daripada JKR. JKR menggunakan platform MyGOS dalam pemantauan potholes, di mana yang saya tunjukkan ini adalah dashboard di kawasan Sabak Bernam dengan total dan keluasan. Seterusnya saya tunjuk daripada Lembaga Getah Malaysia. Dia ada maklumat tanaman getah di Negeri Sembilan dan dia ikut by Estate Felcra dan Felda. Dan akhir sekali saya tunjuk daripada Perbadanan Putrajaya. Dia menggunakan map journal untuk pemetaan taman-taman, tempat-tempat lokasi yang menarik di Putrajaya. So dia menggunakan map journal. Dan ini adalah contoh daripada Perbadanan Putrajaya. Saya rasa itu sahaja. Terima kasih.